Good, thank you. Here we are at Greek Peak. This is what skiing midweek looks like. Hello, you gotta get out. And when you get out, you find a great mountain here at Greek Peak. This is the signage that greets you when you enter. The day I went, it was definitely up to date on what trails were open and closed. Trail lift information, as you saw, and as you're coming across this corner, some character definitely greets you, as well as this huge deck. I can imagine having some drinks out here after skiing. There's the Welcome Center. Across the street is all the lodging available for Greek Peak. They're in the middle of celebrating their 60th year. So here's some information from the marketing team.
So you snowboarded and you skied. Tell me how long you've done both.
I started skiing when I was 2.5 years old. So I've been doing that for quite a long time. When I was 10, I switched. So I'm 25 now and I still do both. It just depends who I'm riding or skiing with. It's a lot of fun and still do it at my home mountain.
Cool. Now, what would you tell someone about Greek Peak that they wouldn't know by not being here? Like,
sure.
Nuances.
Well, I would definitely say for people that are learning to ski, we just launched a new program called Terrain-Based Learning. We partnered with Snow Operating, and we're one of three resorts in New York State that are a part of this group. It's fantastic. It's basically transitioning our learning area into, we shape basically the mountain to teach you how to learn, rather than, you know, falling into your instructor and struggling to try to learn the sport. It's actually shaping the mountain to help you learn, and it's more fun doing it that way. So by having that there, I don't think that any other mountains in the area really have that advantage, which is fantastic. And just the terrain from easier to harder, I think, is a lot better. The progression's a lot better here. And it's a good-sized mountain, so you can ski from one end to the other. You're not going up and down a million times, so it's a lot more fun, I would say, to ski at Greek Peak. And obviously, I have my heart in it because I'm local.
Yeah, no, that's right. The terrain is varied. Before, you kind of told me the mountain kind of goes one way or the other from beginner to expert. Will you kind of explain that?
Yep. So on our mountain this side, you know, the terrain kind of progresses. More of the harder side on the right, and as you progress to the left hand side, it's more of our easier beginner terrain. And then we have our backside mountain, which has a little bit of everything. So if you're learning to ski here, there's everything, every kind of trail in every area. It's not like you start out with a baby hill and just jump to the big guy. So there's a progression, which definitely helps somebody who's learning.
So one of your people told me you guys are talking about a new lift going to that backside.
Yes, yep, that's definitely in the talk for the next few years. Not sure when exactly it's going to happen, but definitely have some capital improvements on the book, so we're super excited. We did launch our train park on one of the trail, actually, that goes right underneath the quad.
Yep.
So it's a lot more visible to you know, everybody that's going up, so they can see what we have to offer. And it might be more intimidating, but really anybody can ski down there. You know, if mom wants to go while their kid is riding the rails and the jumps, they can ski around it. So it's really for everybody, and it's more visible so they can actually see what we have to offer.
That's right. Yeah, I love it. So tell me a little bit about your connection with TOG.
Yes, so Toggenburg is our sister mountain. This is year three that we've partnered up with them. Same owners, different operation. But we definitely utilize it. So if you buy a Greek Peak Pass, you can upgrade to Toggenburg and ski both mountains, and vice versa. So we definitely try to utilize each other, give our customer base the opportunity to ski both mountains. So our teams have worked together, food and beverage, operations. It's really a good collaboration of team to really put our heads together and make the best operation possible.
And how far distance between the two?
It's about 30 minutes, and people really think it's on the other side of the world. So once they drive it, they're like, holy cow, it's really not that far.
So it's just up 81?
Yes, right? Yep, straight off 81, and really door to door, it's about 30, 35 minutes at the most. So it's really not too far to make the extra mile.
Yeah. Awesome. Anything else that I didn't ask you that you would want to tell someone new to there?
Well, I would say, you know, we've really over the past few years developed our season passes and trying to make it fit for everybody. So whether you just like to ski at nighttime, we have a night ski season pass. Jeez, that's a mouthful. And our operation flips to lift access downhill mountain biking in the summer. So if that's something that you like, we have a pass for that and skiing. We have a pass for the water park and skiing. We have a pass for our older demographic, our seniors. So we've really tried to fit in a season pass that works well for everybody, a 25 and under pass to fit that demographic, and maybe at a cheaper price point than they can afford if they're in school.
Yeah,
so
of course. Yeah, college
kids are
just
something for everybody. Yeah.
So the place to start on this quick overview is of the Visions Express Quad. This is a unique loading. There's sensors in those triggers. When your legs get up close, the sensors read you, and they will open when it is safe to go. Allow the conveyor to do the work, and the chair will meander behind you. This took about 3 loads for me to really be used to this process, and I guess on the weekends sometimes there are issues. So be aware when loading and show your kids this video before you come. As you go up the mountain, Elk Mean is underneath the lift, which is a terrain park. When you get to the top, the variety of terrain is phenomenal. I really like Greek Peak as far as the expert terrain mixed with the easier stuff for the adults, newer skiers, or older crew. And tree skiing is prevalent. As you can see, Calypso here is a fun little run with many little chutes. Being on the lift with one of the ski patrol, I found out all of the mountain bike runs here are basically glades as well. Be aware of the signage at the entrance of these glades, because some actually state that ski patrol will not sweep them at the end of the day. So make sure you either go into the glades with friends or let others know. Trees are not the only calling card here at Greek Peak. There are some great steeps, including the 40% grade here of Olympian. But the glades are where I kept going back to. Both sides of the mountain, it's equal distribution, and there are plenty of runs where mothers can take an easy groomer and have their kids in the trees right near them. As you can see going down this run, you can actually circle the bottom of this glade and watch your kids come down. So if there's any issues, you're not far away. This mountain prides on the amount of trees they have for expert skiing. I came away really impressed and realized I could spend a weekend here easily and never be bored. I tried to show you as many of the glades as when I came in here on March 2018. Hope you enjoyed this quick tour of Greek Peak. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and hit the bell for notifications, as I'll be adding more footage all year long. So remember, Greek Peak, 1,000 vertical feet, good mix of greens, blues, and blacks, located south of Syracuse near Cortland, New York. Have a great ski day.